Okay. Now this is just going to be a brief video tutorial on how to use the academic word list. I want to show you two or three things. Now we've got the menu down here with some links, some concordances, some texts. Now the word lists, now these are the academic word lists, so you can just click on the list and you get a link to those. And the one I'm really interested in is the highlighter and the gap maker. These are classic do-it-yourself, self-access learning tools. Now, all you need is some copied text. I've taken mine from the BBC Words in the News site. Great site. Now, up here we've got numbers 1 to 10. 10 is all the words from a list, academic word list. 1 is 10%, 20%, so on. Let's go for about 5. We paste in our text, click submit, wait for a second, and here we get the text with the academic words picked out in bold. So what words have we got? We've got seek help. Ooh, economic downturn, that's a really nice collocation there. Overall aid package, investors' confidence. Now, one point to note here is none of these words are particularly complex, but that's the point about the academic word list. They're not complex words, they're common words. Now, that's phase one. Let's go back a page. Question is, can you now use those words? We'll go to the academic word list gap maker here on the left, click there, and very simple, I hope, we paste in our text again and submit, and now we've got the gapped text to test ourselves. So, to seek help to deal with the something downturn, which one is it? Economic downturn. Now, only one drawback to this program. It doesn't correct you. But in truth, I'm not sure that's much of a problem. Because the natural thing to do now, to see if you're correct, is to go back and read the original text, which isn't actually a bad exercise. Overall, I think this is a really wonderful program and something you should definitely think about using yourself.